my weekly mileage train for a marathon varies, but it's also 7 days a week. Some people ask, do you train every day? I train 12 times a week is what I tell them. So I run every day plus 5 days a week. I'll do second run in the evening or cross training. Running a marathon is pacing yourself. And also in training, it's the same thing. You know, it's not like how fast you can run each day and how fast you can get there. Eventually, you want to do something that is faster than race, and you want to do race pace, and you want to do longer marathon or longer, and then hopefully, when you put it all together, it comes fast time, hopefully get you to the podium or victory or be a personal best, whatever you're shooting for. I don't try to run race pace for a marathon until it has to come to the marathon day. When I do my long runs, you have somebody on the bike. I used to train with people, but I train by myself now. And then also, on my hard days, repeats, tempos, and long runs, the people would have a pacer on the bike. Every 5K, we get special drinks on a marathon day. But the reason I have pacers is just it keeps me moving faster, and they can aid me when I need it to go faster and things like that. You know, when you run a marathon, your posture is very important. And core is very important, because if you strengthen your stomach or your abdominal and your back, you're gonna be more taller. The more taller, your cadence is gonna be better, your mechanics is gonna be better, whereas when we get fatigued, we kind of slouch, we kind of, everything kind of falls apart. So the whole point is, how do you stay tall, stay strong, and then that's to do a lot of core exercises, planks, push-ups, sit-ups, crunches, and all those things. I like to come to Mammoth for altitude training, because you're trying to breathe as much red blood cells as you can, so you, when you go down sea level, they carry oxygen and make it easier for you versus, you know, because sometimes when you're at sea level, you have to push, but here it forces you to slow down. I think personally, it even allows you to prolong your career. So it's not just about the blood cell, but also the scenery is not that bad. You know, I'm 39 years old. I gotta watch out what I do nutritionally. On my hard days, I'll have protein, more protein. On my easy days, I'll have more, you know, just sandwiches, not a lot of protein. And just graze through the day. You don't have to have like big meals. The running is one part of it, but then the nutrition, the stretching, the core, and this gazillion things that you can do day in, day out to improve yourself. Well, my favorite thing about training, about running or sport, the marathon, is, you know, the durability. You know, be able to say, you know what, I've done the work, now can I test myself to execute the plan? And, you know, marathon is patience, so they definitely ask you, don't get too excited too fast at the beginning, but try to control yourself. And then you get excited because endorphin is kicking in, and you're kind of competing with your competitors, and you get that excitement and you want to see how well you're going to do against them. And like Boston or the Olympic Games, they bring the best of the best, and then hopefully may the best man win.